Hello guys, myself Pavan and you are watching Optimistic Coder, and in this video we are going to discuss about jump statements. Everything about it will be discussed in this video, so watch the video till the end. And before that, if you are new to this channel, I would recommend you to hit subscribe if you are interested in Java programming, data structures and all. So let's get started. So basically we have two different types of jump statements. One is break and another one is continue. So we will see each and every one. So let's first go with the break statement. So here in, let's take an example that we have a loop, and that loop is going to iterate for about 10 times, and that loop is going to print out the values from 0 to 9. So if I write a loop and for int I and I initialize with value 0, I less than 10 and I plus plus, so that's my loop. And inside that I'm just going to write a print statement, and I'm just going to print the value of I. So if I execute this particular program, as we have covered the looping statements in my previous video, if you haven't seen, you can go and watch that video so that you will get an idea if you don't know what about loop. So that's the value that we have printed out. Now in this particular loop, if you want that if your value comes up like 6 or 5, the loop should stop iterating and it should come out of it. So for that, you should give a condition like if value of I is equal to 6. In that case, it should come out of the loop and you will write a break keyword. So by writing this, you can actually stop the iteration at that particular instant or that particular point, and it will come out of it. Now if I see the output, it will actually print from 0 to 5, and before printing 6 it is going to break. So if I run the program, you can see it has printed from 0 to 5, and that's the whole point of break keyword. So whenever you want to come out of a particular loop, then you can use a break keyword, and even we use break keyword in switch statements also. So that's the way how you use a break keyword. And let's see about the continue statement. Now continue statement will also work exactly the same, but in a different way. Instead of coming out of the loop, it's actually going to skip rest of the statements present inside the loop. So if you are giving here a continue statement, and after writing that, it actually means that if I iterate the loop, it is going to iterate actually first time, second time, third time, and at the sixth time when this condition gets true, it goes and check, okay, it's saying continue. So it will actually skip out all the lines present inside the loop and it will go on to the iteration part. So let's execute and see, and it is going to actually skip the sixth one, and there you go. You can see it has printed all the values, but it has actually skipped the sixth one. So let me debug this program so that you will get a clear understanding how continue statement works. So if I put a debug point here and I run the program in debug mode, debug as Java application. So here you can see first in the loop, it goes, it checks the condition and it finds that it's not, then it goes and print the value. It happens for the second case, for the third, for the fourth, for the fifth. Till now everything is cool and all the values are printed one by one. In the next case, now the value of I is equal to 6, and which is actually a true statement, right? Now it will get into that, and when it gets continue and this line gets executed, goes up back to this line. As you can see, it haven't executed this. So because of that, we are not getting the value 6. It actually skipped that instruction. So that's the way how we use continue statement and break statement, and that's the whole thing that you need to know about it.